Ryan, how are you finding life as a big, ugly centre-back?
Yeah, I think, obviously, new position, but I think with the style we play here, it's all about playing football, so... Yeah, I suppose the conventional centre-half isn't really what we are here, so we have a lot of the ball, you get a lot of touches, you get to basically like a midfielder really, and so I think in terms of playing style, you know, I'm really enjoying it, and obviously we're keeping clean sheets, so the defending is kind of, is there as well, so you know, I can't really complain.
You do have to stick your head in a bit though, don't you? I mean, you were in a few challenges today.
Yeah, always, yeah, I think after last week, I think today was a minor. I got off light this week, but yeah, obviously, look, as a defender, you're going to have to put your heads in situations and just clear balls, and you know, can't always be, you know, playing football. So I think we're obviously defending well as a unit, and that's, I think, the third clean sheet on the bounce in the league. So we're doing something right. It's just a matter of now of making the most of the chances we get, and today we obviously did and kept clean sheets, and if you do that, then you get up the table naturally.
Have you ever played centre back in your career?
No, I've played a lot of places. I think there's only a few. Keeper is the next one I need to tick off. But no, like I said, it's one of them ones where it's not the conventional centre half in a way. And obviously, even if it was, that's my job. I have to learn how to do it. And if the manager asked me to do it, I learn. I ask the people who were there to coach me, and they coach me, and I take it on board and carry out to the best of my ability.
How much of a relief is it for the squad to get the first home league when you needed it, didn't you?
Yeah, I think it's probably been in common a while now. You know, it's probably a bit of frustration, but I think the performances have been there, which is more important. You know, I think as a group, you'd rather performances were right, but the results just weren't going our way, rather than picking up points, but the performances are poor. So I think things are starting to gel together quite nicely now, and I think we've put together some performances that we can build on. Although I think the game during the week, we obviously lost 2-0, but I still think there was a performance there in the second half, especially where we could have easily come out on top. And I think it's just about things just kind of getting a tiny bit of luck, but also things fully gelling together. And I think, you know, then we'll be in a really good place.
Do you think, I think you've gone up to 17th today with that win. Do you think, you know, this team, this squad should be, you know, looking much higher at the table?
Yeah, 100%. You know, I think we obviously had not the most productive pre-season in terms of there's a lot of change with management and supposed playing styles, and then COVID was absolutely battering us at one stage. So it's kind of, we've had probably a mini pre-season from the beginning of the season. So I think things are starting to gel together quite nicely now, and I think the squad, and definitely with the style of play, you know, and the performances we're putting in, there's definitely no reason why we shouldn't be up there come end of season.
And you touched on last week already. Have you found your shin yet?
I know, I was all weekend refreshing that. 17,000 favourites now. But
you went viral, did you, with that?
Yeah, I know. But yeah, lucky enough, I think I came away, didn't hurt me somehow. You know, I just had to kind of roll with it and see what happened. But yeah, lucky enough, no one was injured, and I suppose that was the main thing from the incident.
His teammate came and had a go at you immediately after watching the footage.
I know locks as well. I used to play golf when I was living in London. Really? So he was messaging me after, go, sorry, but that was the moment. It was actually quite harsh.
Thanks very much.
Yeah, cheers.
I've never seen anything like it, really. For the player not to get sent off for that.
Yeah, look, I think it was such a strange incident that everyone was kind of a bit baffed as to what was actually going on. But look, I think, despite the decisions, you just have to get on with it. I think the main thing was that I had my shin, and I was in good condition to carry on.
Nice one.
Ryan, how important was that second half at Luton after, you know, tough first half an hour to get a draw out of it? Must have been massive for the players.
Yeah, I think in hindsight, we probably were annoyed to not come away with all 3 points in the end. You know, we had a couple of chances that we could have nicked it. But I think that was probably a performance in the second half that, you know, can kickstart momentum and put you on course to go on a little run. I think the goals were coming with a couple of, you know, goalless games against, I think, Hull and Millwall, where we should have got something out of the game, but things just didn't fall our way. So it was coming that we were finally, the floodgates were going to open and we were going to get a few. And we needed that now, and hopefully today was another building block on the last week's performance in the second half, and we just have to keep carrying it into Wednesday night now.
You spoke about playing in various positions. Have you got preference under this regime?
No, just as long as I'm on the pitch, that's all. As long as I'm in the starting 11, I don't mind. But, you know, whatever the gaffer and the staff are asking me, I'll, you know, try my best to carry it out.
Yeah, and I just want to ask about Rhys Williams as well. Obviously, we heard about the incident at Luton last week. He was left out today. We just spoke to the manager and he said he's just trying to make sure he's right mentally. How's he been in the dressing room? And
yeah,
as a player, what have you made of him since?
I think, yeah, Rhys is obviously, he's got Premier League quality. He's come from a massive club, and I think our group is, we're such a good group together, and we've got such a good group of lads that, you know, we'll all look after each other. So, you know, obviously incidents that happened last week are not nice for anyone to have to deal with, but obviously us as a group and I think staff and club, we're all kind of there to look out for him.
Ryan, how nice to have Flynn Downs in front of you today.
Yeah, you kind of, Flynn gets through a power of work, to be fair. It's nice when things drop and he tidies it up and finds the pass and you kind of go, oh, didn't have to go chasing 40 yards after a striker. So, but I think everyone today produced, you know, played exceptional, and I think clean sheet, 1-0 win and probably dominate. I don't know what the stats were, but I'm sure we'd probably dominate a lot of the football. So, you know, everyone put in a great shift today.
Yeah, it looks like you're getting used to that style of play. Just how different is it and how much did you have to sort of take in to sort of get it?
It's obviously it's different to most styles, but you know the management we have here, unbelievable at getting it across to us, and you know every day we train we're getting better and better at it, and I think the manager probably alludes to it at times. Every other team in the league would love to be in our position playing that way of football. So, you know, we're all embracing it and enjoying it. You know, when you come out of a game with 60-70% possession, you can't complain. You know, you look at the other team and go, I'd rather have it than not have it. So, yeah, we're all definitely enjoying it.